Ever struggled to understand pointers in programming? Curious about how they work and why they're important? If so, this is the right video for you. Welcome to Whiteboard Doodles, the channel where we simplify tech-related concepts using whiteboard animations. Today, we'll break down the basics of pointers. By the end, you'll gain insights into pointers and their significance in programming. Let's dive in. First, let's take a look at what pointers are in programming. Pointers are a key concept that allow you to work with memory addresses directly. Instead of storing actual data, a pointer holds the location where the data is kept in your computer's memory. Imagine you have a large book, and you want to remember where a specific chapter is located. Instead of carrying the entire book around, you make a note of the page number where that chapter begins. Similarly, a pointer keeps track of the memory address where a variable's value is stored rather than holding the value itself. For example, if you have a variable that stores the number 42, a pointer can point to the memory address where 42 is located. This means that instead of working directly with the number, you can use the pointer to find and manipulate the value. Next, let's take a look at what pointers are used for. Pointers are used for several key purposes that enhance both efficiency and flexibility in programming. They allow direct access and manipulation of memory addresses, which can improve performance by reducing the need for data copying. Pointers are essential for dynamic memory allocation, enabling programs to allocate and deallocate memory as needed during runtime. They are also crucial for implementing complex data structures like linked lists, trees, and graphs where elements are connected via pointers. Overall, pointers provide powerful tools for managing and manipulating memory, optimizing performance, and creating flexible data structures. Now let's examine pointer syntax in an actual programming language. We'll use C++ for this example. Imagine that you have a variable of type integer that holds the value 42. Initializing such a variable involves defining the appropriate data type, variable name, and value. Now, if you want to access the address in memory where the value of that variable is stored, you would need to add an ampersand symbol before the variable name. When we initialize a pointer, we want its value to be the address of the variable whose value we want to track. So a line like this would create a pointer that tracks the address of our variable with the value 42. If we want to access our original variable through a pointer, we can do so using the following line. This line creates another variable that holds the value stored at the memory address specified by our pointer. At first, this might seem like an unnecessary complication, but in larger and more complex programs with different data structures, using pointers is generally the preferred way. Now let's talk about another aspect of pointers, pointer arithmetic. Like many data types, pointers can be incremented and decremented. However, unlike integers, when we increment or decrement a pointer, we don't change the value stored at the memory location the pointer points to. Instead, we move the pointer forward or backward in memory. For example, consider a pointer that points to a memory location where the value 30 is stored. You can think of memory as a long tape with addresses on each segment. Our pointer points to this specific location, and if we increment it, the pointer will move to the next memory address, which could contain a completely different value or even be uninitialized. If we decrement the pointer, it returns to its original position. Pointer arithmetic allows us to navigate through memory efficiently, especially when working with arrays and other data structures. Now let's talk about pointers and arrays. Pointers and arrays are closely related in programming, especially in languages like C and C++. An array is essentially a contiguous block of memory where each element is of the same type, and a pointer can be used to navigate through this block efficiently. When you declare an array, the array name itself acts as a pointer to the first element. For example, if you have an array named myArray, its name is equivalent to the address of the first element. Pointers allow you to perform arithmetic operations to move through the array elements, such as incrementing the pointer to access subsequent elements. This relationship makes pointers ideal for functions that need to process arrays, as passing a pointer to the array is more efficient than passing the entire array. The interplay between pointers and arrays is crucial for tasks such as dynamic memory allocation, efficient data manipulation, and the implementation of complex data structures. Working with pointers can be tricky, especially for beginners, and often leads to unexpected errors and bugs in the code. To help you navigate these challenges, let's take a closer look at a few of the most common pitfalls when working with pointers, along with their respective solutions. Number 1. Dereferencing null or uninitialized pointers. One of the most common issues is attempting to access or manipulate memory through a pointer that hasn't been initialized or is set to null. This can lead to crashes or unpredictable behavior in your program. The solution for that is to always initialize your pointers when you declare them, even if you don't have an immediate value to assign. Additionally, before dereferencing a pointer, ensure it is not null by adding checks in your code. For instance, use conditional statements to verify that the pointer points to a valid memory address before using it. Number 2. Memory leaks. Memory leaks occur when memory is allocated but not properly deallocated, leading to wasted resources and potential performance issues over time. This is particularly problematic in long-running programs or those that frequently allocate and deallocate memory. To prevent memory leaks, ensure that every allocated block of memory is paired with a corresponding free call or use smart pointers that automatically manage memory. And number 3, dangling pointers. Dangling pointers are pointers that still hold the address of memory that has already been freed. Accessing or modifying memory through these pointers can lead to undefined behavior and crashes. The solution is to set the pointer to null immediately after freeing memory. This ensures that the pointer no longer points to an invalid memory location. Additionally, be cautious when managing memory and ensure that you understand the ownership and lifecycle of dynamically allocated resources. In conclusion, pointers are a fundamental tool in programming that offer powerful capabilities for memory management and data manipulation. By understanding how to use pointers effectively, such as initializing them properly, avoiding common pitfalls like memory leaks and dangling pointers, and utilizing pointer arithmetic, you can write more efficient and flexible code. Mastering pointers requires careful attention to detail, but the control and performance benefits they provide make them an essential skill for any programmer. This marks the end of our exploration of pointers. If you enjoyed it, consider subscribing to our channel and liking the video. Feel free to also check out our other videos on related topics. Thank you for watching.